Hello and welcome to Roving Report, a program that gives you an overview of the developments in India's Northeast region. I'm your host Lumpim Vishyam, and the highlights of today's program are 57 insurgents from three underground outfits bid farewell to arms in Manipur. Underground outfits carry out IED blasts to disrupt peace in Manipur. Silk Reeling Center provides employment to rural women in Tripura. Northeast region attracts investment in hospitality sector. And Manipur's potential in horticulture showcased during Orange Festival. Realizing the futility of violence, many insurgents in Manipur are eager to come to the mainstream. Recently, 57 cadres of three different underground outfits have laid down their arms. We take a look.
Saying farewell to arms. On December 15, a large number of militants from three different outfits laid down arms in the presence of Manipur Chief Minister O.E. Bobi Singh at the banquet hall of the 1st Manipur Rifles Complex in Imphal. The 57 surrendered cadres include the chairman of People's Revolutionary Party of Kangle Park, Pripak, Navachandra Singh, and Finance Secretary Ching Len. 35 surrendered cadres are from Kangle Park Communist Party, KK Nangba faction, and 20 from Kangle Park Communist Party, Nongdreng Komba faction. They handed over a huge cache of arms and ammunition.
Kulai Pairaga, Habadi, Kulai Pairaga Lal Hoba, Adukakna, Imalaba Unshiba, Nate Nekali, Habadi, Tamoy Shangna, Iramdam Buhamadi, Imalaba Kidamak, Hadi, Labour Manipur, Zigamak, Hypatare, Iramdam Zigamak, Makal Amadekta, Hypatare, Kulai Pairagasu, Miam with the Mok of Pavatabak Dorogadi, Habadi, Madusu, Miam with the Mok of Pavatabak Dorogani, Haina, I Lowe and I name Ayumatakali.
A memorandum of understanding was also signed between the Manipur government and KCP KK Nangba group. The government and security forces have assured the surrendered militants that they will be provided assistance in their rehabilitation process.
Violence hingsha si machina koi karigumba waroi sin haibitare solution amta purapanga moi. Haminaraga wari sanaraga ekoina pamba koigi society sida koigi state sida leiriba issues mayam problem mayam singasi haminaraga wari sanaraga masigi waroishin solution purakpa namdani.
Gone away from the normal life, have come back, return back to normalcy. In the past 2.5 years we have been witnessing a lot of groups coming back to join the normal life, and government of Manipur and the central government have been extending full cooperation and support to all these people.
In prolonged insurgency, Manipur has lost a lot. Besides the loss of human life, the economy of the state has largely been affected. The misled youth are slowly realizing their mistake and are returning back to the mainstream. It'll help the return of peace and prosperity in the state.
Underground outfits in Manipur are making all possible efforts to disrupt peace in the state. Recently, two IED blasts were carried out in Imphal city, killing two people. We have a report.
On December 15, a powerful IED exploded at the Mahatma Gandhi Avenue in Imphal city. Two people were killed and at least five others injured. The blast occurred in a godown of betel leaves. Chief Minister and Deputy Chief Minister, along with several top officials, visited RIMS Hospital to meet the injured victims. No militant outfit has claimed responsibility for the attack yet.
There is no room, in fact, for violence. If there is anything that you want to say or express or something, if anybody wants, then you can do it in democratic ways. There are lots of alternative means of expressing the ideas. So I think killing will not bring anything good. It harms everybody.
लगभग साढ़े दस बजे ऐसा होगा. हम तो दुकान के अंदर में बैठा था. तो दुकान गंदा है, वो हम झाड़ू मारता उस टाइम में ऐसे आवाज सुना है. ऐसा आवाज सुना था कि बस गाड़ी का टायर फट गया, इतना जोर से आवाज आ रहा है. बाहर निकल के देखा तो ऐसे होता देखा है.
Earlier on December 11, a powerful IED exploded at Savumbung Faknung Lamkai in Imphal East. A student was injured in the incident. It is suspected that the bomb was planted by militants to attack security forces who regularly pass through that route.
Nasi yam patte ni khali da ai khak ki wan atne ko koi gi public te yam na eno to ba mai tare yam na aki khang na ngan ba de gi atta ni ai tare.
Over the years, violent activities by militant outfits have caused major loss to life and property in Manipur. The locals are tired of living in an atmosphere of fear and want such outfits to shun violence for a peaceful life.
Let us now take a look at some of the events that made news in the Northeast recently.
Students from across the country participated in the 60th National School Games 2014 in Thangta at the Kuman Lampak Indoor Stadium in Manipur. Altogether, 150 players, including 78 boys and 72 girls, under 17 and under 19, participated in the event. The championship was organized by the Department of Youth Affairs and Sports, Government of Manipur, under the aegis of School Games Federation of India, to promote Thangta, a martial arts game. With an aim to promote and preserve ancient folk dramas of Manipur, a festival was recently held at the Roop Mahal Theatre in Imphal. A total of 5 selected plays were staged during the 5-day long event funded by the Northeast Zonal Cultural Centre and Ministry of Culture, Government of India. The Achik National Volunteers Council ANVC of Meghalaya and its breakaway faction ANVCB were disbanded recently at a function at the Dikki Pandi Stadium in Tura. Chairmen of the two outfits surrendered arms and signed affirmation for disbandment with Chief Minister Mukul Sangma in the presence of government officials and hundreds of cadres. Security force personnel, retired officers, Bangladesh Liberation Freedom Fighters and other officials came together in Agartala on the occasion of Vijay Divas to commemorate the 1971 war victory. Chief Minister Manik Sarkar inaugurated a new war memorial on the occasion and paid tribute to the war martyrs. The 1971 war between India and Pakistan had led to the creation of Bangladesh as a nation. A friendship volleyball tournament was organized in Jorhat for the cause of peace and harmony. The tournament held at Titabor and Changpang Circle of Assam and Nagaland was to spread the message of peace, love and harmony among the people living in the border areas of the two states. Altogether, 8 teams participated in the 4-day long event. The second edition of Imphal Expo was inaugurated by Manipur's Deputy Chief Minister Guy Khangam at Iboi Ma Shumang Lila Shang Lane Palace compound in Imphal. The 10-day event, organized by the Manipur Industrial Development Council in collaboration with National Small Industries Corporation, will give a boost to industrial sector in the state. Altogether, 105 stalls showcasing handloom and handicraft items, footwears, electronic gadgets and a variety of other products are being displayed at the expo. A fashion show was also organized to promote traditional attires. Two militants of the National Democratic Front of Bodoland were arrested by the police recently from Tezpur district of Assam. A huge cache of arms and ammunition were also recovered from their possession. A hardcore Ulfa independent militant surrendered before the police in Dibrugarh district of Assam along with sophisticated arms and ammunition. Identified as Raktim Moran, the Ulfa independent lance corporal is a resident of Mudai Gaon and had joined the outfit 3 years ago.
Moving on, the northeastern states have been witnessing a rapid growth in rural and urban areas, especially with the implementation of several government-run schemes. Let's focus on the changing scenario in the region with our segment Ripples. The Northeast region is one of the leading producers of silk in the country, and a large number of people have found employment through sericulture. A silk reeling center in West Tripura is making use of modern technology to boost production and is providing employment to many local women. Take a look.
This silk reeling center at Badarghat in the outskirts of Agartala produces some of the finest quality silk, which is high in demand. Cocoon from various silk rearing clusters and cocoon collection centers in West Tripura are collected here for taking out silk threads. Over 40 locals, mostly women, are engaged at the center in various stages of silk production and are able to earn well besides availing facilities like health insurance and pension.
শ্রমিকরা উপকার হইছে মহিলা শ্রমিক আমরা 33 জন আছি মহিলা শ্রমিক স্বামীও যা রুজি করে আমরা নিয়া দেই পাশাপাশি এতে স্বামীর একটু উন্নতি হয়
With help from the Central Silk Board, the government-run center has undergone modernization with 8 semi-automatic reeling machines and other facilities. In 2012, the state's first power loom silk production center was started here as well.
আমাদের এখানে ত্রিপুরাতে যত সেরিকালচার ক্লাস্টারগুলি আছে সেইগুলি থেকে এখানে আমাদের এখানে গুটি আসে সেই গুটি থেকে আমাদের স্পিয়ার সিল্ক সুতা তৈরি হয় এবং সিচুয়েশন আগে যতটা ছিল আমি এখানে আসার পর যতটুকু দেখেছি দিন দিন উন্নতির দিকে যাচ্ছে প্রফিটের পথেই চলছে সবটাই
Over the years, both the states and central government have been giving a lot of priority to boost silk production by introducing a number of schemes to encourage locals to take up sericulture. The state government has increased the total area under mulberry cultivation, which has considerably increased raw silk production.
In Tripura, whatever silk saris and other fabrics are this produced, these are going to outside Tripura, that is in neighboring country, as you are telling, Bangladesh, they are also very much interested and they have come and they have seen our quality of the silk yarn and the raw fabric and some of the company, business partner, those who have come last year during Handloom Expo, National Handloom Expo, they have visited and they have taken also and they have told that they will take in a bulk quantity.
The Northeast region is famous for producing a variety of silk products, including the Muga and Path fabrics of Assam and Tripura silk saris.
The Northeast region is fast catching up with the rest of the country in terms of infrastructure development and investment activities. Recently in Guwahati, the first 5-star hotel of the Northeast was inaugurated and more such hotel developers are now pouring into the region. Take a look.
Guwahati, known as the gateway to Northeast, has become a growing hub for trade and commerce activity. In the last few years, the city has witnessed a mushrooming of shopping malls, showrooms, apartment complexes and hotels. The changing face of the city, coupled with an expanding tourism sector, is attracting many investors. Recently, the first 5-star hotel in the region, Radisson Blue, was officially inaugurated. The hotel group is prospecting to open hotels in the state capitals of northeastern states.
I think Northeast has great potential. The infrastructure and connectivity to rest of the country is increasing every day. the population here is very well literate, educated, modern, and they want to experience a hotel like this. As more businesses come in, and of course the tourism opportunity that Guwahati offers, or generally Northeast offers, all those can be built on further as long as there is good accommodation for people who come to stay is available.
This hotel is a proof that everything is really going on well here. It's a standing example of how nice this part of the country is, and I think there's a lot of potential in Assam, a lot of potential in the Northeast, and I see a lot of development happening. This will encourage a lot of other developers, a lot of other operators to come into this lovely part of the country.
With a booming economy and a steadily growing tourism sector, the hotel industry will only further expand. Three more five-star category hotels are coming up in Guwahati city. The growth of hospitality sector has also opened new job avenues for the youth in the region.
Almost 70% of the employee, the team members, are from Northeast, and 60% is from the state of Assam itself. It is very important. Also, it is a platform for a lot of young hoteliers who are working in this hotel to get groomed, and get trained for the next level, which is very important for them.
It's amazing. Hotel, first of its kind in Northeast, in fact, entire Northeast, it has created a lot of interest and has generated a lot of job opportunities as well.
The gradual return of peace and normalcy has brought about significant socio-economic change in the entire Northeast. And in the coming years, it will prosper manifold.
Climatic conditions in the Northeast is favorable to horticulture. Manipur's Tamenglong district, which is known as the orange bowl of the state, hosts an annual festival to demonstrate the variety of oranges it produces. The annual event is a major tourist attraction. Take a look.
The annual orange festival in Tamenglong district is to boost the morale of orange growers in the region as they bring the best of their products to win an award. This year, more than 300 orange cultivators participated with a variety of orange crops. Inaugurated by Chief Minister Ibobi Singh, the mega event helps to motivate other farmers in the region to grow oranges.
It is to promote the orange grower, plus to plan systematic and scientific method of plantation for these orange growers.
The annual occasion also helps to promote tourism in the state. Performance of folk dance troupes from different parts of the state enthralled the visitors. Handicraft stalls were also put up to promote local artisans. As part of the event, 22 girls walked the ramp for Orange Queen Beauty Pageant title. After a tough competition, Kapa Gonglui of Tamenglong backed the crown. Ajuwana Kami of Tamenglong remained as first runner-up and Mirinda TK from Palel second runner-up.
I feel so surprised and I'm so happy, and I really thank God. Without His help, I cannot win this crown tonight.
Such festivals not only promote progressive farming, but promote tourism in the state.
With that, we have come to the end of this episode of Roving Report. Do connect with us through our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter at @anyindia_ANI. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel to get latest news updates from the Northeast. I'm your host Lumpim, signing off with some images of the Sikkim Winter Carnival 2014. Goodbye and take care.